إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الإخوة الحضور، بالنيابة عن أعضاء غرفة تجارة وصناعة أبو ظبي، أرحب بالشيخ أحمد ديدات مرة ثانية في الغرفة، ولقد تركنا له اختيار الموضوع، وسأترك الأخ بدر يقوم ب الاشتراك بتقديم الشيخ. الشيخ أحمد ديدات معروف لديكم، فلا أحب أن أطيل في الكلام، وأرحب به مرة ثانية وشكرا. تفضل بدر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أسعد الله مساءكم أيها الأحبة في هذه الليلة المباركة. يسعدنا أن نستضيف الداعية الإسلامية الكبير الشيخ أحمد ديدات، والذي تفضل مشكورا بإتاحة هذا الجزء من وقته الثمين لكي يلقي الضوء على الإسلام في أفريقيا، والذي هو سوف يكون عنوان محاضرته لهذه الليلة. وفي البداية أشكركم على هذا الحضور، وأسأل الله يعني أن ينفعنا ونفعكم بعلمه وما سوف يتطرق إليه. سوف يعقد المحاضرة فتح باب النقاش للأسف، فأي من الأخوة لديه استفسار أو سؤال عقد المحاضرة يمكن أن يدوم ملاحظة حتى أن يتسنى له السؤال. وأشكركم مرة ثانية، والآن فليتفضل الشيخ أحمد ديدات مشكورا. ونحب أيضا أن نشكر الدكتور عبد المنعم بلة الذي سوف يقوم بالترجمة الفورية. بالنسبة للأخوة الذين يتكلمون الإنجليزية، هناك ترجمة فورية للغة العربية ممكن يحصل على ترانزليتر على الشانل رقم 3، وفي أيضا نسخة الصوت. ونشكركم أيضا مرة ثانية، وتفضل الشيخ.
تفضل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله، وكفى بالله شهيدا. صدق الله، صدق الله العظيم. Chairman and my dear brothers and sisters. الحمد لله. All praises to Allah, that Allah has made it possible for me to be here tonight. I'm very, very grateful to Allah. And I'm also very grateful to the Abu Dhabi Chamber of Commerce and Industry for gathering you all here at almost at a minute's notice. Yesterday around 1 o'clock, I happened to visit the chamber, and the young and energetic Vice President, Brother Muhammad Al-Utayba, is suggesting to me that I speak to the people, to the chamber. I said, okay. I was imagining that the people were ever ready. They were just around the corner and go to a small room or a hall and address them. I said, right. But this is no, we'll arrange a meeting. I said, no. All the people together, you know, all the members are thinking that they're all agreeing somewhere along. Let's call them. We want to organize a few days. I said, no, I haven't got the time. I have to leave tomorrow. I have to leave for Dubai. He says, no, you deliver a lecture in the evening. I said, in that case, I leave Monday morning for Dubai. Okay. So I agreed, and alhamdulillah, I just can't believe my eyes that at a minute's notice, so many brothers and sisters can gather, you know, to listen to a humble servant of Allah as I am. We are an exception. As soon as I arrived in the UAE, I read in the newspapers about another brother from Africa, from Tanzania, an ex-bishop of the Lutheran Church, Martin John Moyopo. That's the surname.
I'm saying that that brother from Tanzania, that ex-bishop, he has three advantages over me. It's yours. The Quran is yours. Your guess. You won't get hurt. What are the advantages? Yes, brother.
Ex-bishop.
Number one, that he was a Christian.
Christian parents.
No, that's the same thing. Christian ex-bishop, right? What else?
He is a native of
Africa. He is a? Three advantages. You see, somebody has got one, somebody has got the other, somebody has got something else. Three advantages are...
He became Muslim without reading Quran.
MashaAllah. Three advantages are, number one, he's an ex-bishop, accepted. A Christian who has embraced Islam, naturally, the very fact that he has done so, when we advertise, it's a provocation. To the Christian, they want to attend, they want to challenge him, they want to ask him questions. How? Why? Who bribed you? You know, for a woman's sake or what? Why did you accept Islam? So he will be a draw card. Number one, from the point of view that he is a new brother in faith. He has left Christianity and accepted Islam. Number one. Number two, his color. You see, his color in Africa is an advantage. Your color and my color, maybe it was very handsome, very beautiful. But to the African, you are suspect. He suspects you. Where were you all these years? You come all of a sudden now and you are talked about Islam. What's your motive? Maybe you're terrified of us. You want to curry favor with us. Diamond cuts diamond. There's a saying that diamond cuts diamond. And we have a saying in the Zulu language that you need a sharper thorn to take out a thorn. You know, thorn, when it pricks you, you want to take it out. If you haven't got the needle or the pin, you need a sharper thorn to take it out. Diamond cuts diamond. Black man, the color, is an advantage, which I haven't got. And number three, I am 74 years old. He's half my age. So he has got 50 years ahead of him. Mine is 50 years behind me, you know, pushing me forward. So these are the three advantages he has. Alhamdulillah, I'm praying that may Allah Bari Ta'ala make somebody, encourage somebody, inspire somebody to send him over to South Africa on a lecture tour. Islam in Africa. An American historian by the name of H.G. Wells, W-E-L-L-S, Wells. In his book, The Shape of Things to Come, he says, Africa is a fair field for all religions. Africa is a fair field for all religions. But the religion which the African will accept is a religion which best suits his needs. And that religion, everyone who has a right to speak on the subject says, is Islam. Religion for Africa. What about Europe? George Bernard Shaw, he said that if any religion has a chance of conquering England, nay Europe, within the next 100 years, he said that religion is Islam. Allah says, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى. He it is who has sent his messenger with guidance, ودين الحق, and with the religion of truth, ليزهره على الدين كله. That it may prevail, overcome and supersede every other deen. كله. وكفى بالله شهيدا. Another place, he said, ولو كره المشركون. Now mind how much the mushrik might not like it. This is the destiny of his deen. To master, overcome and supersede them all, bulldoze them all, whether it be Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianism, Communism, every ism, Islam is destined to master them all. And Allah says, وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِدًا, and enough is Allah is a witness to this fact that he's going to make his deen to prevail with you or without you. It's a privilege Allah has given us to serve his deen, to do the works of the prophets of God and earn a prophet's reward. We are not taking it. Somehow things have gone wrong with us. We are not doing our job. The Arabs, our ancestors, the Arabs, your forefathers,